glory, Osborne. But sometimes we throw a pity party.
Yes.
And God saying, yes. My servant, I have a great word for you to do. Yes. You're only going to carry this thing. So she took Samuel and she had to place him into the temple.
Yes.
Amen.
Now at this time, Eli, he was getting a bit old. But the Bible said that Eli did not run his house well. He had sons and they were doing evil in the temple. He knew of it. He never corrected.
Yeah.
He never tried to fix it.
That's right.
He never even put them out. Uh-huh. And said, you can't defile the temple of God.
Amen.
But when they taught that, this belongs to me, God was raising up Samuel.
Yes.
So now Hannah's job was finished. Now it's time for Samuel to come forth. She was only the carrier. And so, when Samuel came forward, he was a godly child.
Yes.
And he stayed in the temple, and Eli trained him. And he trained him in the ways of how a priest should, the job of a priest. And the Bible said that Eli, glory to God, God was getting ready to move Eli. God was getting ready to move him. And so God spoke to Samuel. But Samuel was not familiar with the voice of God.
Amen.
And so he called Samuel the first time. But you see, Samuel was familiar with Eli's voice.
Yeah.
Saints of God, because sometimes we are not in that place where we can really hear God speak.
Amen.
He used the voice of our leaders.
Amen.
And sometimes we have dreams and we'll say, Pastor, you came in my dream and you said this to me. That wasn't Pastor, that was God.
Amen.
He used him because you know the voice of your pastor.
Yes.
And so Samuel knew the voice of Eli.
Amen.
And so he went to Eli. And he said, did you call me?
Amen.
But Eli was in his own way.
Right.
Eli didn't even realize that the first time that God was calling Samuel.
Uh-huh.
He did it a second time. He said, Samuel.
Amen.
Samuel answered and he went to Eli.
Yeah.
Then Eli realized that it was the Lord that was calling Samuel.
Amen.
So he said, go and lay down. And when you hear that voice again, say, speak, Lord, thy servant.
Amen.
Amen.
Women of God, men of God, we have to train the young people to hear the voice of God.
Amen.
Amen.
It's okay for them to come into church and we say, clap your hands and stomp your feet. But in other words, we have to train them in godly ways.
Amen.
Sometimes we say, oh, these children just doing what they want to do. Yes, but if you train them in the ways of God, they should not depart from it. They have to come back to it. I don't care how far they go. You can sleep on your bed with assurance. They have to come back to God. We have a task.
Amen.
It's good to say that I am saved.
Yeah.
It's good to say I'm in the church.
Yeah.
But you ought to bring your child up in the fear of God.
Yeah.
In our nation today, in our church. children reach a certain age, you don't have to go to church. Stay home, study. Uh-huh. Oh, you have extra school work or activity, you go to that. That's okay. God understands. We don't pray with them. We don't teach them the word of God.
All right,
our lifestyle, we may say we're saved, but in our conversation is not seizing with grace.
Amen.
And so the children are hearing daily what's going on. They are not to church, but they can tell you who is Sister Mary and who is Brother John and where Sister Harry live, or what they wear, or what they have on, what they said in church.
Mercy, Lord.
But yet, we are saved and sanctified. And the devil is making a halo out of our children. Glory be to God. I'm not going to say that sometimes when children go there and do wrong because their father, no, I'm not going to say that because I know that's a lie.
Amen.
I'm not talking to you. But I'm talking to those that refuse to grow up their children in the admiration and the fear of God.
My God.
If we will go back to the time, we will know some of us was just like Hannah.
Yes.
We mourn and we cry daily.
Yeah.
God, I needed a child. But yet when God gives you the child, what did you do with that child?
My God.
Did we act like Eli? Did we allow them, even when they were in church, they can do whatever they want? And that's okay, but that's not okay with God, because God had given you something. God had given you a gift, and so you ought to bring them up in the ways of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because, you see, when we are living for God, and we go, sometimes, you know, we get crazy. And we say, I don't mess up the devil camp.
That's right.
Oh, that devil is coming back. I'm not boosting him, but I'm going to tell you, he's coming back.
Yeah.
And wherever he see a vacancy, baby, he's going to make a haywire out of that sea of vacancy. And so when you in church having all the Holy Ghost and you casting out devil, he say, I'm going to work in this one. Because you didn't even bring them in the house of God to get the covering over their lives. The call of Samuel. The young people are very special.
Yes.
I don't care, sometimes they do things to make your head spin. Are you wondering, where did I go wrong? It's because you got a jewel in your midst.
My God.
And because the devil don't want them to reach their full potential, because out of your wounds he had blessed the seeds of your wounds. And so if he had blessed the seeds of your womb, they will rise up and be greater than you are.
Yes.
And so before they reach their destiny, the enemy tried to take them out. But we're not going to boost in the devil. But we are taking our young women. We are taking our young men back. And we say drugs, you will not have them. We say prostitution, you will not have them. Oh my God Almighty. We are taking them back. I say, God, this is my son. gifts. It's coming amongst our young men. And society wants us to example. That God has given me a woman, and he wants to, and she wants to be a man. And endless of prayer. Hushanda Makoshanda. The devil is surely a liar. For my God, hallelujah. That is my Esther. That is my Deborah. She shall rise and she shall be great. Male child that born a male.